Good morning, guys. Today we have to start with type 3 LSA, but first of all we will discuss about how to control SSH, how to control access on SSH. Fine. So what I will do, on R1 I will enable SSH. Fine. First of all, R2 will be able to SSH R1, but after that I will block R2. Fine. Any issues between 1 and 2 IP address will be steps for enabling SSH. First command, host name must be defined. Host name is defined. Second command, domain name must be defined. Domain name is sysop. Let it be. Third, enable crypto key generate. Username, password, next line VTY 02, login, local, SSH is enabled. Any issue? I will move on to interface FA0/. SSH minus L test 1200. Password. I am getting the access. R1, R2. When R2 will try to SSH R1, source will be 1200. It means I have to block this source on R1, agree? But the thing is, you don't know about ACLs. What you have to do is, guys, I am telling you some things about standard ACL. A brief introduction about standard ACL. What are standard ACLs? So before starting with standard ACLs, try to understand a simple thing. In a network, there are only two things. One is host, second is either you can permit. See, what is ACL? ACL stands for access control list. It means I am controlling the access. Here 12002 is remotely accessing R1, agree or not? So what I am doing here, I am controlling the access. I am controlling the access. So if I have to control the access, either I can give access to a network, or either I can give access to a host. This thing is clear. Either I can block access for a network, or either I can block access for a host. Agree? It means whenever I have to use ACL, there will be two things. One is host, second is network. Which thing will differentiate these two things? Question is, which thing will differentiate these two things? इन दोनों को डिफरेंशिएट कौन करेगा बताओ? सबनेट मास्क. इफ आई राइट इट लाइक दिस 12.0.0.0, 0.255.255.255. What is this? Wildcard. In ACLs, we always use wildcard mask. This thing is clear. So this thing will match what? Network. Agree? But if I will write it like this, 12.002.0.0.0.0, what it will match? IP. Agree? This thing is clear to all of you. So now in standard ACL, there is a rule. Rule is, if you permit anything, what do you mean by permit? Permit means allow. Deny means block. Agree? Now, if I permit anything, every other fucking thing will be denied. What it means, when I permit something, every other thing will be denied by default. And when I deny something, every other thing will be denied by default. It means, when I write first statement as permit, so that particular thing will be permitted, other things will be denied. Clear? If I deny something, this thing is denied, but all other things will also be denied. Agree? So if I am writing a deny statement, after deny I have to write a permit statement. It's necessary. Not permit all. She will be in pain, man. Okay. This thing is clear. That was just a joke to make you understand. So, if I permit something, every other thing will be denied by default. Agree? If I deny something, then also every other thing will be denied. So, ACL will work on a sequence. ACL will work on a sequence. Sequence means, when you create a ACL, you will be configuring statements in the ACLs. What you will be configuring? Different statements. ACL will check all statements step by step. Okay, now. एक मिनट भाई 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 मजाक खत्म वीडियो स्टार्ट फाइन यस
परमिट जैसे ऑन कर दिया अब अंकुर और पवन भी
टट्टा मारूंगा अंकुर और पवन क्या है डिनाइड अदर देन अंकुर एंड पवन ऑल अदर आर परमिटेड दिस थिंग इज क्लियर एंड इफ आई राइट दिस स्टेटमेंट आफ्टर अस्मत देन अस्मत इज ऑल्सो दिस थिंग इज क्लियर सो दिस इज द नॉर्मल रूल फॉर access control list. And which access control list?
Standard.
This thing is clear. So till now in ACLs, what we have studied? That in ACL we can allow or deny either network or host. I will differentiate network and host on the basis of wildcard mask. On the basis of okay. Okay, leave it. So next thing, there is a rule. If I permit anything, all other things will be denied. If I deny anything, all other things will be denied. So please keep in mind, if you have deny statements, permit statement must be in the end. Clear? All things will be permitted. Yes. Guys, look here. Now, on R1, I have to block 12002, agree or not?
Yes.
See, in standard ACL, always source is matched. Always source is matched. Just try to understand. That girl was still same. You are just a source who are coming in. Agree? So in standard ACL, what thing is matched?
Source.
Okay. On R1, first of all, what I have to do? I have to create a standard ACL. IP access list standard. Now there is a number of something you can create in named ACLs also and a numbered ACLs also. Fine. We will discuss this thing in detail when we will discuss about ACL. Fine. So you want to create it by number or word? By a name? What name? Sorry. Deny. This is a name. Deny 12002. Applied. What I have to deny? I have to deny host or network? Host. A single IP. I will write here. Which host? 12002. Agree? On which router I am? On which router I have configured SSH? R1. This thing is clear? If I deny something, all other things will be. So after this, I will write a statement. Permit? Any. Permit?
Any.
This thing is clear? Fine. Now, line BTY024. In which mode I am? Line mode. What I will do here, I will write a simple command. Access class. After access class, press question mark. What he is asking for? This is my ACL name. Direction. On a router, client will always send a request into the router. Client will always send a request into the router. This thing is clear? See, there can be two cases. R1, R2. Let's take an example. This is R3. Fine. This router is sending request into the router. From this router, you are SSHing this router. This thing is clear? So, whom you can SSH? Kisko aap SSH kar sakte ho, jab aapne kisi router ko SSH pehle se hi kiya hua hai. See, just try to understand. From R2, I am accessing R1. Agree? Now, I want to go out of R1 to R3. Actually, I am on R2. So, this time direction will be out. When I am accessing R1, direction will be in. But now from R1, I am on R1, I want to access R3. Direction will be out. This thing is clear? What I am trying to say, you can access from one session to another session. Maine ek bar access kiya kisko? R1 को, R1 को एक्सेस किया हुआ है, R1 को एक्सेस किए मैं किस पे जा सकता हूं? R3 पे. तो वो डायरेक्शन क्या होगी? आउट. और जब मैंने R1 को एक्सेस किया, वो डायरेक्शन क्या थी? इन. क्लियर? देखो, समझो. अ वेरी सिंपल. आई एम R1, यू आर R2, यू आर R3. फाइन. ऑन अस SSH इज कॉन्फिगर्ड. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, यू आर एक्सेसिंग मी. You will access me, you will send a request into me. This thing is clear. That's why direction will be in. Now, you are on your router, you are accessing me. Now, from this session, you want to go to? Already you are on a virtual line. Already he is on a? From this virtual line, you want to move on to his virtual line. So, direction will be out. This thing is clear. So direction will be in. Fine. Connection refused by? Why? Because of? Show. What is the command to check the access list? Show IP. How many matches are there? Because this user is denied. This user is denied. This thing is clear. Any issues? Egg one, bro. Guys, this is sequence number. This is sequence number. So, what router will do, whenever you will create ACLs on the router, router will by default assign a sequence number at a gap of 10, 20, 30, 40. Now there will be a question in your mind. Why router is not assigning a sequence number like this? 1, 2, 3, 4. Just think like, you have created 5 statements. Now you want to add something in between. So you have a option. So you can add something in between. We will discuss it in more detail when we will come to ACLs. This thing is clear. Today topic for the discussion is एक से ज़्यादा access list बन सकती है। पर वो एक लाइन पे नहीं लगेंगे। You cannot apply on the same line. On different lines you can apply. चार लाइन ऊपर कर रखी हर एक पे अलग अलग लगा दे। Benefit क्या होगा उसका? एक वे था अच्छा सोचने का, but this that thing will not give me a benefit. और जो हम ACL पढ़ते हैं, when okay, बाद में ACL के टाइम पे बात करेंगे अभी. This thing is clear. I have applied ACL on my lines. Why on lines? Because I am controlling line access. Because I am controlling. Now guys, today our topic, I will start from type 3 LS. Now R1, type 1 and type 2 is clear. R3, R4. Let's say this is my diagram. Now guys, till now we were discussing the concept of a single area. Today we will start with multiple areas. First of all, what is the need of multiple areas? Agree? This question comes in your mind. So let's say this is one area. There are 10 routers. And you know one thing. Every router must have database of all other. It means there is a chance that my router has to, or you can say my router's processing will increase and it has to contain a lot of. Just to reduce the database on the router, we have the concept of multiple areas. Just to reduce the load on the router, we have the concept of multiple areas. This thing is clear. Now, R1, R2, R3, R4. I am saying here I am running area 1, here I am running area 2, here I am running area 3. So what do you think? This router will give information of area 3 into area 2 or area 2 into area 3? Why? These are different domains. This router will never give information of area 3 into area 2 or area 2 into area 3. Why? These are different domains. So how inter-area communication will take place if this router will not give the information? It means this router has to give the information from area 3 to area 2 and area 2 to area 3. See, under single process ID, I can call multiple areas. This thing is clear. So process ID will be same for both the areas. This thing is clear. So what I am trying to tell you here is R1, आर टू आर थ्री आर फोर एरिया वन एरिया टू. दिस राउटर विल ओनली गिव वन एरिया इंफॉर्मेशन टू अदर एरिया इफ इट हैज कनेक्टेड एरिया जीरो. इफैक्ट इट हैज कनेक्टेड एरिया जीरो. Now there is a question in your mind, why this is the condition? Why this is the condition? Why don't this router can give information of area 1 into 2 directly? There will be any problem? Okay. Let me assume a case. That this router is able to give information of area 2 into area 1, area 1 into area 2. This router will also give area 3 into area, area 2 into area 3. Agree? Let us assume these routers are giving or exchanging inter area information without area zero. अब तक सबको समझ में आ रहा है हम क्या बात कर रहे हैं? सबसे पहले मैंने एक मुद्दा उठाया. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई डिस्कस द पॉइंट, डू टू एरियाज विल एक्सचेंज इंफॉर्मेशन, यस और नो? यस दे विल एक्सचेंज, बट देर इज अ कंडीशन, देर मस्ट बी एरिया जीरो इन बिटवीन. So now I am discussing the reason why it is necessary to have area zero in between. Fine. Now look here. At this time, in this exchange, there will be no problem. There will be no problem. But if I have a design like this, area 1, area 2, area 3, area 4. From this router's perspective, this router will give information of area 2 into area, area 1 into area. This router will give 3 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 1 into 4 into. At the end of the day, every router will be getting routing information from every other router from two sides. Agree or not? That will cause loops. That will cause loops. To prevent these routing loops, we have a condition that two regular areas will only exchange information if they have area zero in between. If they have area zero. Now there is area zero in between. Area three information will be given in area zero. Area one information will be given in area. Area three and four will never directly communicate. Area one and four will never directly. If they have to communicate, we have a solution. But that is not in CCN. This thing is clear. If two regular areas want to communicate, there is a solution, but that is not in. You are clear with the reason that why we need area zero in between to prevent routing loops. This thing is clear. Now, R1, R2, R3, 4. This is area zero. This is area. This is area. Now, these areas can communicate. And guys, there is a special name for this router, ABR. ABR stands for area border router. हाँ जी, थ्री का नेम भी क्या होगा? ABR. थ्री का नेम भी क्या होगा? ABR. Now, first of all, एबीआर एक स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट राउटर होना चाहिए. क्या होना चाहिए? एबीआर मस्ट बी अ, बिकॉज एबीआर इज द राउटर हु हैज टू हु विल बी हैविंग डेटाबेस ऑफ एरिया वन ऑल्सो एंड हु विल बी हैविंग डेटाबेस ऑफ एरिया और एनी अदर एरिया विच इज कनेक्टेड टू एबीआर. दिस कैन ऑल्सो बी अ केस गाइज, प्लीज मेक योर थिंकिंग वाइड. This is area one, area three. This can also be a case. Here I can have a router, here I can have a router. So this ABR will be having it all information of area two also. Zero also, one also, and three also. This thing is clear? 2, 1, 3, all the areas information will be stored in ABR. This thing is clear? Now, what is the use of ABR? ABR will transfer one area information into another and another information into other. एक एरिया की इंफॉर्मेशन दूसरे में दे रहा और दूसरे की पहले में. कैसे? इन फॉर्म ऑफ टाइप 3 LSA, दैट इज कॉल्ड समरी LSA. दैट इज कॉल्ड समरी. गाइस, टिल नाउ इन अ सिंगल एरिया OSPF was acting like but when we move to इंटर एरिया कम्युनिकेशन OSPF विल वर्क लाइक इट डज नॉट मीन्स दैट देर विल बी अ हॉप काउंट, देर विल बी नंबर ऑफ हॉप्स. डिस्टेंस वेक्टर व्हाई आई एम सेइंग, बिकॉज ऑल राउटर्स इन अ सिंगल एरिया, इफ दे वांट टू रीच the routers in the other area, they are dependent on ABR. They don't know the exact database of other area. Agree? So what information ABR will send? Just think like this is R2, this is R3, this is R1. Here I have a loopback, here I have a loopback. This is area 0, this is area 1. So what this router will called? ABR. This router will send this network information. This network is let's say so in area 1 summary LSAs, which LSAs will be X, network is second is network is A, second thing will be mask, third thing will be cost, third thing will be, and who will advertise these LSAs in area 1? R2. It means ABR. This thing is clear? This router ABR will send its own cost to reach these particular networks. It's on course to reach these particular networks. Now, in area 0, type 3 LSAs will be, summary LSAs will be network Y, network B. After that, there mask. After that, cost. Agree? So, let us take one more example. R1. R2, R3. A X Y B. This is cost is 1, 10, 10, 10, 10. Fine. Now, area 0, area 1. In area 0, summary LSS will be network Y, network B. Mask, their cost. Its cost 10. Now, in area 0s, when R2 will give this LSA to R1. Try to understand a simple logic. Logic is, this cost is from ABR to that particular network. ABR to that particular network. So for B network cost will be 10 plus 10, 20. This thing is clear. Now, R1, when R1 will make its routing table, R1 will add its on path cost up to the ABR. मैं क्या कहना चाहता हूं, जब भी एक ABR summary LSA forward करेगा एक एरिया में, तो वो अपनी कॉस्ट बताएगा उस नेटवर्क तक की. मैंने आप एरिया जीरो, मेरे पीछे एक एरिया चल रहा है एरिया वन. मैं जब भी एरिया वन के नेटवर्क्स आपके एरिया में फॉरवर्ड करूंगा, तो मैं किसकी कॉस्ट बताऊंगा? अपनी. भाई वो नेटवर्क मुझसे कितना दूर है? 10 कॉस्ट पे है, तो वो आपसे कितना दूर होगा? आप पहले अपनी कॉस्ट मुझ तक पहुंचने के लिए कैलकुलेट करोगे और उसमें उस कॉस्ट को क्या करोगे? ऐड. समझ में आई ये बात? जब भी एबीआर टाइप 3 एलएसए जनरेट करेगा, वो तुम्हें डायरेक्ट कॉस्ट नहीं बताएगा. वो किसकी कॉस्ट बताएगा? अपनी. भाई मेरे से वो पर्टिकुलर नेटवर्क इतना दूर है, तो तुमसे कितना दूर होगा अपने आप कैलकुलेट कर लेना. देखो, हम सब एक ही एरिया में है, एग्री? आपको मुझ तक आने की कॉस्ट पता है, तो मैंने आगे की कॉस्ट आपको बता दी. ये कॉस्ट आपको पता है, ये आप खुद कैलकुलेट कर लो. दिस थिंग इज क्लियर? तो अगर हम इस एग्जांपल में लें, तो वाई की कॉस्ट कितनी फॉरवर्ड करेगा? जीरो, बिकॉज वाई इज अ डायरेक्टली कनेक्टेड नेटवर्क. दिस थिंग इज क्लियर? तो राउटिंग टेबल में फॉर वाई नेटवर्क, फॉर आर वन टू रीच वाई नेटवर्क कॉस्ट विल बी 10. व्हेन आर वन हैज टू रीच बी नेटवर्क कॉस्ट विल बी 30. कॉस्ट विल बी 30. ठीक है जी, कोई इश्यू? इट्स नॉट लाइक एफ डी एन एडी. कॉस्ट इज सिंपली एडेड. वेन एवर एबीआर विल एडवर्टाइज, FD and AD is a totally different concept, man. Formula is different, way of adding is different. Yeah, you can compare it like that. Yeah. Forwarding manner is same. Yeah. So guys, R1, R2, R3, R4. Let's say this is area 1. This is area 0. This is network X. This is network 1. So, how many type 3 LSAs will be there in area 0, area 1? 1, 2, 3, 4. Type 3 LSS will be equal to number of networks in a area. Number of networks in a area. Kyunki, because I will be giving information of all the networks from one area to another area. This thing is clear? Summary LSS in area 0. How many submarine LSNs will be there? Two. One, two. भाई किसी को क्लियर नहीं हुआ था पूछ लो, हो गया भाई क्लियर पक्का? एबीआर कौन, एबीआर विल, एबीआर कौन सी कॉस्ट फॉरवर्ड करेगा, कौन सी कॉस्ट फॉरवर्ड करेगा? अपनी खुद की कॉस्ट। भाई मेरी, मेरे से ये नेटवर्क इतना दूर है, अपनी मुझ तक कॉस्ट कैलकुलेट खुद कर लेना। दिस थिंग इज क्लियर? एबीआर कौन से टाइप का एलएस जनरेट करेगा? टाइप थ्री। दिस थिंग इज क्लियर? प्रैक्टिकल। आफ्टर दैट वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट टाइप फोर एंड टाइप। एक बात और यार, इधर देखो सब लोग। नाउ इफ आर टू वॉन्ट टू रीच आर वन, हाउ मेनी पाथ्स आर देयर? टू। वन इज दिस, अदर इज दिस। व्हेन आर टू हैज टू गिव इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट नेटवर्क एक्स इन एरिया वन, देयर विल बी टू कॉस्ट, वन दिस एंड वन, विच कॉस्ट इट विल फॉरवर्ड? लोएस्ट कॉस्ट। विच कॉस्ट? लोएस्ट कॉस्ट। दिस थिंग इज क्लियर? ओके। बिटवीन वन एंड टू वी विल रन एरिया जीरो, बिटवीन टू एंड थ्री वी विल रन एरिया वन। सो हेयर आर टू इज एक्टिंग एज अ एबीआर बिटवीन वन एंड टू, नेटवर्क इज बिटवीन टू एंड थ्री, नेटवर्क इज ऑन वन। आई विल क्रिएट अ लूप बैक, Now, before starting with type 4 and 5, we have to discuss one process, that is हमने रिप में डिफॉल्ट इंफॉर्मेशन ऑरिजिनेट डिस्कस किया था, ठीक है. इन EIGRP वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट हाउ टू ऑरिजिनेट डिफॉल्ट राउट. ओके, हाउ टू EIGRP प्रोसेसेस विल कम्युनिकेट. ओके, वी विल स्टार्ट विद दैट थिंग. R1 R2 दिस इज R3. लेट्स से हियर आई एम रनिंग विच प्रोसेस AS100. हियर आई एम रनिंग विच AS. What I am talking about? By default, EIGRP will never give roots of AS100 into 200 and 200 into. Why? What is the reason behind this? See, we have a behavior like this, that AS100 roots are never given in 200 and 200 are never given in. Why we made a behavior like this? See, in EIGRP, how many matrices we have? 5. There can be a chance that one AS is using only bandwidth and other AS is using only delay. So how the other AS will able to understand its metric? Clear? So this is the by default behavior, that one AS information is never forwarded into other AS and other AS into AS information is never forwarded into first AS. Because there can be a chance they are using different K values for calculating their metric. This thing is clear. Now, if you want to make this communication possible, that process is called redistribution. Redistribution means transferring one protocol information into another. Or in technical words, you will say, injecting one protocol roots into another protocol. Injecting one protocol routes into another protocol. This thing is clear. किसी भी protocol के साथ. Yes, communication between different protocols is called redistribution. Fine. So, if you have to inject routes in EIGRP 100, you will go in router EIGRP. What you will write? Redistribute which process? 200. This time 200 process, 200 routes will be injected into. 200 routes will be injected into process 100. Now you will go in router EIGRP 200, redistribute EIGRP 100. This time 100 process 100 routes will be injected in 200. Now guys, some people ask me this question, sir, this is R1, here we are running AS100, this is R2, here we are running AS, in this case there will be no redistribution, because for redistribution we have a condition. On same router, you must be running both routing protocols. On same router, you must be running both routing protocols. This thing is clear. Then only that router will be able to inject routes from one routing protocol to another. This thing is clear? This thing is fine. See, now R1, R2, R3. Here we are running RIP. Here we are running EIGRP. What you will write? Router, RIP, redistribute EIGRP. After that, you have to define one thing, that is called metric. Why? Try to understand a simple thing. On R2, EIGRP routes will be having a metric. That metric will be calculated from which values? K1 and? But in case of RIP, metric is hop count. So you have to tell R2 that whenever you will inject EIGRP routes into RIP, what will be their metric? What will be there? So R2 can carry forward that metric to R1. This thing is clear, because these two routing protocols have different metric. Whenever you will inject one routing protocol routes into another routing protocols, you have to define metric. Normal सी बात हमेशा याद रखना, जब मैं redistribute कर रहा हूं किसमें, RIP में, metric क्या आएगी? Hop count. Now I am in router EIGRP, redistribute. इसका मतलब क्या है? मैं बोल रहा हूं EIGRP में किसके routes insert कर दो? RIP के. Metric किसकी आएगी? किसकी मेट्रिक आएगी? EIGRP की. किसकी मेट्रिक आएगी? यार रूट्स किस प्रोटोकॉल में जा रहे हैं, तो मेट्रिक किसकी आएगी? अगर जब RIP में जाएंगे तो EIGRP में जाएंगे तो OSPF में जाएंगे तो, और कहीं मैं स्टैटिक को रिडिस्ट्रीब्यूट मारूंगा, स्टैटिक की कोई मेट्रिक होती है? डू स्टैटिक रूट हैव एनी मेट्रिक? नो. तो उसमें मेट्रिक डिफाइन करने की जरूरत नहीं है. दिस थिंग इज क्लियर? This thing is fine. Okay. Look here. In this case, this router is called redistribution router. This router is called redistribution. आपके Facebook पे mutual friend होते हैं? Mutual friend का मतलब क्या होता है? Redistribution. Mutual redistribution means I have to redistribute EIGRP into and RIP into. म्यूचुअल फ्रेंड मींस वो आपको भी जानते हैं और उसको भी जानते हैं. एग्री? सो द रूट्स विल बी नोन बाय EIGRP आल्सो एंड EIGRP रूट्स विल बी नोन बाय RIP आल्सो. सो म्यूचुअल रिडिस्ट्रीब्यूशन मींस आई एम रिडिस्ट्रीब्यूटिंग फ्रॉम RIP टू EIGRP एंड फ्रॉम EIGRP टू RIP. दिस थिंग इज क्लियर? दिस थिंग इज फाइन? सर पढ़ा. सिंगल डायरेक्शन करने का बेनिफिट, कम्युनिकेशन नहीं होगा कभी भी. इफ यू रीडिस्ट्रीब्यूट इन अ सिंगल डायरेक्शन देयर विल बी नो कम्युनिकेशन. व्हाई? यू आर टेलिंग RIP अबाउट EIGRP रूट्स, ट्रैफिक विल बी सेंडेड, हाउ रिप्लाई विल कम? इज इट पॉसिबल? नो. सो फॉर कम्युनिकेशन यू नीड व्हाट थिंग? म्यूचुअल रीडिस्ट्रीब्यूशन. जैसे दो अनजान दोस्तों की बात कराने के लिए एक म्यूचुअल फ्रेंड जरूरी होता है. ठीक है जी? हर एक फ्रेंड जरूरी होता है. यू हर्ड दिस लाइन? ओके. तामरी तुमरी हर फ्रेंड जरूरी. तेलुगु तामरी तुमरी हर फ्रेंड जरूरी. दिस इज तेलुगु मैन. सर्च ऑन गूगल. इज क्लियर? नाउ R1, R2, R3. हियर वी हैव नाउ दिस राउटर इन OSPF इज कॉल्ड एज ASBR is the name given, special name given by, for which routers? Redistribution routers. So ASBR will give it a name as, OSPF will give it a name as ASBR. और सब router routing protocols इसको क्या बोलेंगे? Redistribution router. लेकिन OSPF इसको क्या बोलेगा? OSPF will call it as ASBR. This thing is fine. Now, in OSPF, there is nothing called routes. Agree or not? Everything is in the form of database, or you can say LSAs. Agree? It means which router is responsible for injecting external LSAs into OSPF? ASBR. Agree? Which router is responsible for injecting external LSAs into OSPF? What we call that router? हाँ भाई, समझ में नहीं आ रहा? आ रहा है कहीं पे ना आए तो बता दियो भाई, लाइन रिपीट करना आप, करना लाइन रिपीट।
सर जब हमारा डिफरेंट एएलएसए कम्युनिकेट करेगा तो वहां पर एक्सएमएल, तो वहां पर हमें एएसपीआर की नीड।
मैंने बोला विच राउटर इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल, कौन सा राउटर रिस्पॉन्सिबल होगा किसी और राउटिंग प्रोटोकॉल्स के रूट्स को ओएसपीएफ में लाने के लिए, कौन सा राउटर होगा? एएसपीआर। ठीक है जी, क्योंकि एएसपीआर पे हम क्या परफॉर्म करेंगे? रीडिस्ट्रीब्यूशन। ठीक है जी, इतनी बात समझ में आई? विच राउटर इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर परफॉर्मिंग रीडिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इन ओएसपीएफ, दैट राउटर इज कॉल्ड, इट मींस एएसपीआर विल इंजेक्ट एक्सटर्नल एलएसएस इनटू ओएसपीएफ। सी एक्सटर्नल एलएसएस कंटेन इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट नेटवर्क्स बिलोंगिंग टू डिफरेंट राउटिंग प्रोटोकॉल। क्या लिखा मैंने? दिस थिंग इज क्लियर। इट मींस ईआईजीआरपी नेटवर्क्स इन ओएसपीएफ आर स्टोर्ड इन विच एलएसए? एक्सटर्नल एलएसए। दिस थिंग इज क्लियर। हु विल जनरेट एक्सटर्नल एलएसए? एएसपीआर। हु इज, हु विल बी एडवर्टाइजिंग राउटर फॉर एक्सटर्नल एलएसए? एएसपीआर। एग्री? दिस थिंग इज क्लियर। नाउ ऑटोनॉमस सिस्टम बॉर्डर राउटर, जो मेरी एएस का क्या है? बॉर्डर। जो मेरी एएस को क्या कर रहा है? डिवाइड। जो दो डिफरेंट राउटिंग प्रोटोकॉल्स को क्या कर रहा है? डिवाइड। दिस थिंग इज क्लियर। द राउटर विच इज डिवाइडिंग टू डिफरेंट डोमेन्स इज कॉल्ड एएसबीआर, बट इट इज ओनली कॉल्ड एएसबीआर इफ वन डोमेन इज ओएसपीएफ, इफ वन डोमेन इज। दिस थिंग इज क्लियर। नाउ दिस एक्सटर्नल एलएसएस आर कॉल्ड टाइप 5 एलएसएस, फॉर देम एडवर्टाइजिंग राउटर इज ऑलवेज एएसपीआर। दिस थिंग इज क्लियर। दिस थिंग इज फाइन। हाँ भाई वीरे, कोई दिक्कत? पूछ भाई, क्या ऑरेंज टी शर्ट यार, इसका नाम भूल जाता हूँ मैं हमेशा, गुरदीप बताओ, कोई दिक्कत? पक्का ना? अब देखो आगे, ये आर वन, ये आर टू, आर थ्री, ध्यान से देखना, अब आर फोर, दिस इज एरिया जीरो, दिस इज एरिया वन, हेयर वी आर रनिंग विच प्रोटोकॉल? इट मींस दिस राउटर विल एक्ट एज, दिस राउटर विल एक्ट एज एबीआर। पहले हिंदी में फिर इंग्लिश में, फाइन, ध्यान से सुनना। एएसबीआर विल जनरेट विच टाइप ऑफ एलएसए? टाइप 5। इन टाइप 5 एलएसए इज कॉल्ड एक्सटर्नल एलएसए। फर्स्ट थिंग, व्हेन एवर आई विल रीडिस्ट्रीब्यूट ईआईजीआरपी इनटू ओएसपीएफ, आई हैव टू डिफाइन मीट्रिक, दैट मीट्रिक इज कॉल्ड कॉस्ट, एंड दैट मीट्रिक इज स्पीड प्री डिफाइंड, दैट इज कॉल्ड, द वैल्यू इज 20. There is no need to define metric for the routes which are redistributed in OSPF. Metric is predefined. The value is 20. Clear? It means whenever I am redistributing something into OSPF, there is no need to define metric. Metric is predefined. The value is 20. It means R4 will redistribute which LSS? Sorry, which routes? External routes into OSPF in the form of which LSA? Who is generating this external LSA? R4. Let's say router ID for R4 is 4.4.4.4. It means who is the advertising router? 4.4.4.4. 4.4. How? Because they belong to same area. This thing is clear. Guys, all of you know this thing, that router ID can be an existing IP and cannot be a. Agree? R4 will give this type 5 LSA to R3. R3 will give it to R2 and in this area also all routers will be having which LSA? Type 5, but advertising router will be 4.4.4. In area 1, all routers knows who is 4.4.4 because they belong to same area. Agree? But in area 0s, nobody knows who is 4.4.4. Why? Because 4.4.4 belongs to a different area and 4.4.4 can be existing IP and can be a non-existing IP on a router. This thing is clear. So, to give information of ASBR in area 1, 2, all the routers in area 0, this ABR will generate type 4 LSA. Will generate? First of all, do there is any need of type 4 LSA in area 1?
No.
Because all routers know about ASBR. All router knows about? Is clear. Second thing, ABR will generate which LSA? Type 4. Which LSA?
Type 4.
Type 4 is also called ASBR summary LSA. ASBR, it means R3 is actually giving summary of ASBR into area
0.
Clear? Should I repeat it in Hindi? Now, listen to me. इस पर्टिकुलर एरिया में हर राउटर के पास टाइप 5 LSA है. सबको पता है ASBR कौन है? सबको पता है, क्योंकि वो सेम एरिया से बिलोंग करते हैं. एग्री? अब ये LSA इस एरिया में आया, एडवर्टाइजिंग राउटर अब भी कौन था? R4. इस एरिया में पहली बार राउटर्स को ये नहीं पता कि ASBR कौन है. दूसरी बात, ये नहीं पता कि ASBR तक के जाने की कॉस्ट, what is the cost to reach in the area 0, no router knows this thing. Agree? So ABR will generate which type of LSA? Type 4. Type 4 LSA is called ASBR summary LSA. Is called ASBR summary LSA. In ASBR summary LSA, R3 will tell every router in area 0 about two things: who is ASBR in my area and what is the cost to reach the ASBR? What is the cost to reach
ASBR?
This thing is clear. So in area 1, sorry, in area 0, who will spread information about ASBR?
ABR.
Who will generate type 4 LSA?
ABR.
Type 4 LSA is called
ASBR
summary LSA. दोबारा सुन लो लास्ट बार. R3 एक्चुअली एरिया 0 में बताता है क्या कि एरिया 1 में ASBR कौन है और उस तक पहुंचने की कॉस्ट मुझसे कितनी है. किससे कितनी है? तुम्हें कॉस्ट कैलकुलेट करनी पड़ेगी अपने से मुझ तक. दिस थिंग इज क्लियर? दिस थिंग इज फाइन? Any issues? So five types of LSAs are clear. First, router LSA. Second, third, fourth, fifth,
external LSA.
Every router who belongs to a single area will generate type 1 LSA. Agree? On a multi-access segment, there will be type 2 LSA. ABR will always generate type 3 LSA. Purpose of type 3 LSA: inter area
communication.
ABR will advertise networks of one area into another area with the cost to reach those networks. Cost kitni hai meri un networks tak pahunchne ki? Do information hogi ab type 3 mein. Type 4 LSA:
वेरी एक्सटर्नल नेटवर्क नाउ, तो ये भी आप टाइप 4 LSA जनरेट नहीं करेगा.
When type 4 is generated, when there is type 5. When there is no type 5, there will be no type 4. This thing is clear? Fine. And all of you know when there will be a need of type 4. Type 4 की जरूरत कब पड़ेगी ये भी सबको पता है. जिस एरिया में ASBR होगा उस एरिया में टाइप 4 की जरूरत नहीं पड़ेगी. दिस थिंग इज क्लियर. R1 R2 R3 गाइस हियर वी आर रनिंग EIGRP. फाइन. दिस इज how to inject. We have studied the same thing in RIP. In RIP what we did, we define a default route on this router and on this router we run the command default information. The same thing we will be doing in EIGRP also. How? First of all we define a default route on this router, then we will redistribute that default route. What we'll do, we will redistribute that default route with the command redistribute static. Whenever you will write the command redistribute static, there is no need of defining mitrig. Why? Because by default static route has mitrig of 0. This thing is clear. R1, R2, R3. How to inject default route in OSPF? On R2 you will define a very similar to RIP. You will define a default route. On this router you will run the command default information. This router will generate a type 5 LSA for that default route, because that default route will be external. This thing is clear? This thing is fine? Any problem? Fine. Passive interface is clear to all of you? So your routing is complete. Khatam. Love you. Come man. Not here. Okay. R1. R2. Okay. I will take an example like this. You are asking about path vector routing protocols. Guys, path vector routing protocols are protocols like BGP. Fine. They will select the path on the basis of number of AS, never on the basis of number of hops. Never on the basis of number of what is AS? A full domain. They will count a AS as a domain. Okay. Fine. Just think like this is service provider. Who is this? This is AS1, this is AS2, this is AS3, this is AS4. Here I have a customer router. Fine. He want to reach. He want to reach Tata. So, how many AS he has to cross? One AS. Just think like there is one more in between, let's say Vodafone. So in this case how many AS he has to cross? 2. In this case only one. It means best path is selected on the number of AS, never on the basis of hops or never on the basis of bandwidth or something. Fine. We select best path on the basis of number of AS. We will discuss about it when we will discuss BGP. किसने IGRP मैंने पढ़ा ही नहीं यार कभी बुक में दिया हुआ है फिर डाउनलोड तो कर ला हाँ जी वी हैव अ नेटवर्क टाइप कॉल्ड लूप बैक गाइस देयर इज अ कांसेप्ट इन OSPF लाइक आई एम डिफाइनिंग अ लूप बैक एट /24 1.1.1.0/24 This is my loopback. Whenever OSPF will advertise this loopback, OSPF will advertise this loopback at /32. Why? Because for loopbacks, OSPF has a network type called loopback. And OSPF consider this particular loopback as a end host. End host means a single IP. This thing is clear. So at what mask you are creating the loopback, OSPF doesn't matter. OSPF will always advertise that loopback at /32. So if you want to advertise that loopback at exact mask at which it is defined, what you can do is point to point or broadcast, you can change it to any network type other than loopback. Because if network type will be loopback, it will always be advertised at /32. This thing is clear. ठीक है भाई, start करते हैं यार. पहले आपका question NBMA वाला. पहले उसकी बात बता दे. Bounded or unbounded. Guys, what do you mean by bounded updates and what do you mean by unbounded updates? Concept is very simple. Some people are there, जिनकी girlfriends हैं और वो उनसे क्या है? Bounded. और some people जिनकी girlfriend है फिर भी क्या है? Unbounded. Fine. Here, girlfriend is my neighbor. Girlfriend is my neighbor. Bounded means I will send only updates to the only neighbors which are affected by that update. Which are unbounded means I will send to all of them which are affected or not affected. Let's take a example. Guys, EIGRP supports manual summarization. EIGRP supports manual summarization means you can create a summary. If you have some networks that belongs to same subnet, you can create a summary for those networks. So let's take an example R1, R2, R3, R4. Fine. Here we have some networks. Here we have some networks. R1 is giving these networks simply to R2. R2 is summarizing them and giving them to. It means R2 is giving a summary to R3. This thing is clear. Now, there is a change in this particular network. Fine. So, R1 will give the update to R2. R2 will give the update to. But never give it, will never give it, give a update to R3. Why? Because R2 is not giving specific network information to R3. R2 is only giving a summary. It is only giving a. This particular thing is called bounded updates. EIGRP will always generate bounded. It means it will send updates only to the neighbors which are affected by that update. See, R3 will never be affected by this particular update. So R2 will never forward update to R3. This thing is clear. But if we take a same example in OSPF, updates will be unbounded. It will be traveled to all the neighbors. Why? Guys, because in case of OSPF, all routers have same database. All routers have same
database.
This thing is clear. So bounded means I am giving to the updates. I am giving update to the neighbors to whom I am bounded. Unbounded means I am giving neighbors update to the neighbors to whom? To all the neighbors. This thing is clear. This thing is fine. Now your question. Yes. Chapter number. Bro, chapter. ये पढ़ लिया सारा. कहाँ है एनबीएम में? कहाँ पढ़ा था यार, बताओ तो. पढ़ा था यार, देखा था ब्रो. कहीं तो रीडिंग तो कहीं तो की होगी. यही एरियाज के बाद ये ठीक है. क्या बोल रहा है, पढ़ो बड़ा करूं. रीडेबल है? हाँ जी. क्या बोल रहा है, कोई तो पढ़ो. ब्रॉडकास्ट पढ़ पहले. इतनी बात समझ में आई? इन केस ऑफ ब्रॉडकास्ट वी हैव द कांसेप्ट ऑफ डीआर एंड बीडीआर. नॉन ब्रॉडकास्ट पढ़ो.
नॉन ब्रॉडकास्ट मल्टी एक्सेस नेटवर्क आर नेटवर्क सच एज फ्रेम रिले एक्स डॉट.
ये लाइन पढ़ो.
दिस टाइप ऑफ नेटवर्क.
दीस टाइप्स ऑफ नेटवर्क. दिस नहीं है.
दीस टाइप्स ऑफ नेटवर्क्स अलाउ फॉर मल्टी एक्सेस
विदाउट ब्रॉडकास्ट एबिलिटी लाइक ईथरनेट. इट मींस on these particular networks we don't have broadcast ability or we don't have multicast ability. It means I cannot directly send a hello. It's like this. Here he has given example of frame relay. What is frame relay? Frame relay is a layer 2 service. Is a, see, this is service provider. He is giving this service, this router, this router. Which service? Frame relay. What is saying that this router is not able to multicast, is not able to send multicast hello through this service provider, because on this media multicast is by default not allowed. So these networks are called NBMA, non broadcast multi access networks. See, it is similar to a switch. It is similar to a switch, but in this case broadcast and multicast is not allowed. That's why we call these networks as NBMA, non broadcast multiple access. We will study this full technology in when we padhenge how frame relay works. Fine, this thing is clear. Haan bhai, aur bhi question tha kisi ka? Bounded unbounded aapne pucha tha, aap kuch pooch rahe the.
Point to
एक राउटर को स्विच के साथ कनेक्ट कर देते हैं, कर देते हैं यार एक बार। तो मैं एक नई चीज भी दिखाऊंगा। अब सही चल रहा है ना? देखा प्रैक्टिकल टाइम पे ही चल रहा था। OSPF enabled, show IP OSPF interface, OSPF enabled, show IP OSPF database, which type of LSA is generated? Type. Wait for some time, show IP OSPF. ठीक है, आपको यहां कहीं टाइप टू LSA दिख रहा है? देर इज ओनली राउटर LSA, देर इज नो टाइप टू। दिस राउटर इज इलेक्टेड एज अ DR, यू कैन सी हियर, दिस राउटर इज इलेक्टेड एज अ, बट देर इज नो टाइप टू। व्हाई? ऑलवेज कीप दिस थिंग इज माइंड, दिस थिंग इन माइंड, जब तक मेरे पास BDR नहीं होगा, टाइप टू LSA जनरेट नहीं होगा। Type 2 LSA generate. If I have a single router on a segment, there will be no type 2 LSA for that segment. It means I can conclude this thing that if this is my scenario R1, R2, this is switch and here users are connected for this network, there will be no type 2 LSA. This thing is clear because there is no BDR. There is no BDR. This thing is clear? समझ में आई ये बात? जब तक BDR नहीं होगा तब तक टाइप टू LSA प्रेजेंट। यार जब तक कोई देने वाला ही नहीं है, आई डोंट हैव एनीवन टू गिव टाइप टू LSA, व्हाई शुड आई जनरेट इट? देयर इज नो नीड। दिस थिंग इज क्लियर? समझ में आई आपकी बात थी? जो इस केस में टाइप टू LSA कभी भी जनरेट नहीं होता अगर यूजर्स कनेक्टेड है। एक और राउटर लगा दो, हो जाएगा।